Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Brave Soul Frozen Dungeon on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5, that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. It packs a punch with mega performance upgrades and it has faster performance than any other high-end Android device or Android platform. We will be able to easily download and install Brave Soul Frozen Dungeon and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Brave Soul Frozen Dungeon. So without further ado, let's get to it. First of all buddies, the first thing to do is to launch our favorite web browser. We open the one we prefer. Let's go to the current URL that I have highlighted in green color. There you are seeing it on the PC screen. You don't need to type this URL, because I added a link in the video description and the first pinned comment. We landed at this point on our internet site of Usitility, in which we get a detailed overview on how to obtain Brave Soul Frozen Dungeon on PC. We scroll lower a bit and press on the Download Game on PC button. Once we click on that link, we land here on the site of BlueStacks, which the Android emulator that we will run to get access to this game Brave Soul Frozen Dungeon on PC. It is now obvious that we access a number of advantages of using the emulator. Now we are on the way to proceed to download the Brave Soul Frozen Dungeon by simply clicking on this button play on BlueStacks that I have marked in green. We then click on this button, and the download step starts and ends immediately. Voila! Here is located the download. It's an executable file. The following step is to launch the executable file, so we click on the file. If we are on Windows 10, it will have asked us for permission to allow changes to the system. We clicked yes. I minimized the web browser to see the installation software better. The installer is very simple. It consists of two possibilities, install and setup path. I am going to explain what setup path actually does. We merely click it, and we realize that we have here the path in which the emulator can be set up. If we wish to change for better this directory, we have to click on the Browse option, and we select another directory and install the emulator exactly where we want. I am going to keep it where it is. Then, I click on Back. And I just click on Install. Now, there it is. The install starts and it's going to commence together with the download of these MB that are shown on the computer screen. Once you save it on your hard disk, it may be more or less megabytes. The download speed might go faster or at a lower speed, determined by your web access and depending on the data transfer rate of the emulator servers. Now they are running very fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5, you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance-related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. Now, the emulator has actually been launched immediately. As you can see, at the bottom of the screen, there is a progress bar which will move forward to the right so when it gets to the ending, the emulator will be launched for the first time. In fact, the emulator has been launched here for the very first time. Before we continue, as now you can see, it has created two app icons right here on the PC desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks Multi-Instance. Note that the BlueStacks app icon is the one we are concerned about. Anytime we are planning to run Brave Soul Frozen Dungeon on our PC, we double-click on this particular app icon and therefore start the emulator. The BlueStacks Multi-Instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Let's conduct the next step, which is actually a must-have, and that's to access the Google Play Store. And we will just click on Play Store. As you can see, the Google Play is presented. Here we must log on. Now once we are right here, we must definitely begin doing the next phase, which is compulsory. So we mouse-click on Sign In. Now it announces, checking info. It can in some cases get stopped at, checking info, and this does not proceed. If so, you may try to connect to your account after a number of hours but it will surely almost certainly be corrected. Now we can enter our email and password. The email must be a Gmail email and its related password. For example, you make use of the same email you are using right now in your YouTube account. So I am going to provide my details and I'll return when I have accomplished it. That's it, info entered. Below is Google welcoming us and supplying us the terms of service. We would accept all of them by clicking, I agree. Next, it allows us to back up to the Google Cloud. You might keep it checked and it will generate a backup of the data on that device to Google Drive. I am not going to select it, you can use this option if you desire. We click on accept. Google Play is started by default and immediately. To set up the app game, we need to get to the emulator desktop by left-clicking this app icon marked in green. Now that we are discovering the desktop of the Android emulator, we notice that we now have here the install app game button. We mouse-click on the button. Here we come with the game. Let's quickly just click there on the install button that I'm just highlighting now in green. And it will launch the installation. At this time it would download on your desktop or laptop and install the Android game. It might take a little while or it may possibly be very fast. This all will depend on our web connection. It has actually completed setting up. Now, let's go to the emulator desktop by simply clicking this option I'm presenting in green, in order to use Brave Soul Frozen Dungeon for the first time. We are presently on the emulator desktop, and then we're preparing to just click on this fresh Brave Soul Frozen Dungeon icon which has been created. The game app is launched for the first time. So there we get it, I can mouse click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I will talk about the volume of this emulator. This is here. We have the icon of higher volume along with the icon of lower volume. This way we are not going to depend on the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the audio of the emulator. And to appreciate the experience to the fullest, we should activate the big screen, for which we have two alternatives. This is simply the first one. We simply click on that software icon that I am basically pointing out in green. And the display screen is maximized, having one border on top, one at the right and the third one at the bottom. If we choose to enjoy the app using all the screen, we press on this software icon. And we might already be experiencing the Android game in full screen mode. To escape the full screen setting, press the F11 key. And we'd already end up being in standard computer screen mode. Now I am on the way to show you the keys mapping and that is actually very useful. This means we will be ready to use the video game more easily. The first thing is to click on this computer keyboard icon. And there you will have the ability to make the appropriate controls. I am about to leave the normal configuration, however if you want to improve it, you can also do it without any problem. As you can see, the emulator is fully in our language. Occasionally it occurs that the emulator is launched in the erroneous language, for example, in Chinese language. And to set it up in the right language we click here to the cogwheel. And right here within various other controls, we just click on the language drop down. We could determine the language we want, Spanish, Chinese, and so forth. Once the language is selected, we would save, the emulator would restart, and the video game, the next time we use it, will as well be in the opted for language. Now, you can find another detail that we need to take into consideration, and it's that we will receive a message from Google saying that a brand new device has been connected with our Google account. It should ask us if we are the ones who have connected that device. Of course, we may not be troubled, as the emulator is simulating a Google Android device. And to determine which device is currently being emulated, we come back here, to the cogwheel and we just click on it. And we browse here to the model option. And there we observe that the emulator is acting as a Samsung cell phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all guys, so much for the video tutorial. I sincerely hope you enjoyed it, especially that everyone found it handy. If so, bring it a good like, subscribe to the channel, and I will be happy to answer your comments, questions or suggestions, let them in the comment area down below. You also can leave a remark on my Twitch channel, I actually do live streams from time to time, you get it below in the video description and in the very first pinned comment. Just click any of these online videos that happens to be showing up on the computer screen and see you in the next videos. Bye.